Welcome to the Chef's Kitchen. I'm your host, Tinamarie, and today I'm joined by Chef Anthony Bonett.
Hi, how you doing?
Hi, from Alison's at Bluebell. It's great to have you here.
Thank you.
And our special guest, Derrick Gunn from Comcast SportsNet.
Tina, how are you?
I'm great. How are you?
Good. Thank you for having me on today.
Great to have you cooking in the kitchen with us.
Well, I don't know what I'm doing, but we'll give it a shot.
It's all improvisational, so we'll see. We're in great hands with Chef over here.
That's
so we'll just take his lead.
All right.
Now, I know we have something interesting we're cooking today.
We do. We're going to
What do you think of that, Derrick?
Well, my first comment is it dead?
It is dead.
Because if it's not, I don't want PETA looking for us. That's a little different. I'm not used to
that. Are you intimidated by that?
The last time I saw that, it was on the other side of a glass in an aquarium. So that's a little different for me.
I know you can handle it.
But I am confident you're going to make this into a masterpiece,
right,
Chef?
No, it's very good. And you know what? A lot of people have eaten octopus in restaurants, and it's one of those things that they really enjoy eating. And most people will not cook it at home. I mean, I'm sure some people might, but
you
have to be a little bit adventurous to cook it at home.
Believe it or not, I made a great octopus salad last year.
There's a lot of choices with octopus. This is a really high quality frozen product. It's a Spanish octopus.
It's a Spanish octopus. Is that different from the regular?
It is very different, and it commands a higher price. The majority of octopus you eat at restaurants is either like Chinese or Filipino.
Okay.
It's not bad, it's just a lower quality.
Are they smaller?
The Filipino and Chinese are about the same size, but they have like thinner tentacles.
Okay.
And they kind of cook up a little differently, and they don't really have that nice, rich. It's the same thing with like shrimp. There's a lot of different kinds of shrimp, and some shrimp have much better flavor.
Sure.
Like the Spanish octopus, the industry that produces it is just a really nice, the fishing industry is great, it's really controlled.
Mm-hmm.
And you know, they catch these octopus out at sea, they lightly brine them, and they freeze them immediately, and it just ends up being a really nice product, and I really taste a big difference in it when I cook it, so I always go back to this product. Now, there's other, like baby octopus you can find, you know, a lot of Japanese restaurants have baby octopus, so there's a lot of choices with octopus, and it tends to cook up very kind of like neutral flavor, and has really good, you know, you can add a lot to it. It almost cooks up like chicken of the sea.
You
really
can dress it up good.
You really can.
Yeah, I noticed that when I made octopus.
So this is about 4 to 6 pounds. And sorry,
it's
dripping all over the place, but
now,
the whole thing's edible. There's no waste in it at all. There's a little tiny bone in the middle, and we'll take that out when we cook it.
You can show us how to do that.
Yeah, that's right there, and it's really small. It's almost just like a beak you would see on squid.
Okay,
so that's the only piece that's inedible, and the rest of it's edible. So it really has good yield, and so it's all around really nice piece of fish.
Are you an adventurous eater, Dad?
Hey, you know what? I'll give anything a try once, but do smaller octopus taste better than the larger ones?
I like the large ones. I like this one for this preparation. I'll show you know how we cook it. It does take some cooking time, and we have one done. The small ones cook nicely. You can saute them real quick, and you can kind of like cook them in sauce for maybe like 10, 15 minutes. They come out real nice. But the large ones, you know, for me, mostly any fish you want to have, the bigger ones have better flavor. You know, big tuna, big striped bass, you know, big octopus. Mm-hmm. It goes with that too.
All right. So do we get started with this octopus?
We're gonna do a technique that I picked up. I've cooked octopus a lot of different ways, and you'll read a lot of cookbooks, and there's a lot of different ways to cook octopus. Some people boil it, you know, for hours and hours.
That's how I cooked it when I made octopus.
We got a pan a little bit hot with olive oil, and we're just gonna put it in there. And let it kind of sizzle on the olive oil. And you can once you get it in there, turn your heat up a little bit. So be careful, you know, it doesn't splash all over you. So you need a pretty big pan to do that.
So you're actually sear it?
We're going to sear it, saute it, and we're going to end up, it's going to let out a lot of juice. And when it does that, so the octopus itself, a lot of people add a lot of liquid to their octopus, like they'll add white wine, red wine, or water. And we're going to find, and we'll show you when you cook this, and we'll move on. And let it sear for a little bit, but you'll see it's going to let out like it. It's already doing this.
It browns very quickly,
It really does. It turns really nice and red, just like shrimp. It is a shellfish, so it's going to cook up red at first, and then it'll kind of like change colors a little bit. But you want to get that initial redding because it's going to add a lot of flavor to the bottom of the octopus. And it's going to like leach out all this liquid, and this liquid is what we're going to cook it in.
It's good, the good stuff.
Yeah, so it
probably
has really
a lot
nice
of flavor.
Nice flavor, nice salt. You don't have to add any salt to it.
Mm-hmm.
And you're going to end up with just a really, really nicely flavored piece of octopus that tastes like
and
the sea
cooks,
and kind of salt.
Right, mm-hmm. Derrick, it gets a little bit more aesthetically pleasing. It loses that gray hue, right, that we're a little intimidated by. But
I'm still fascinated by the fact you have this thing in a pan.
Yeah.
I'm trying to get over this.
You ever eaten octopus, Derrick?
No.
To be a first for you.
It's kind of, from what you're telling me, it's kind of like frying bacon in a pan, right?
It looks like it's the same, similar technique.
Yeah, you're just going to get a little color on it. That's it.
Right.
But you'll see octopus in like Greek restaurants, Italian.
Oh, I mean, sure.
A lot of trendy restaurants now have octopus on their menu.
Italian. I'm Italian. I grew up with octopus.
It lends itself to a lot of different preparations.
The octopus that I cooked was very economical. I was shocked at how inexpensive it was.
No, it's good. I mean, this is really, when I say expensive, it's still like $5.50 a pound.
Right. This is amazing.
And there's 100% yield on it. So compared to shrimp, that's like $15 a pound.
Is there a big difference in the taste between octopus and calamari?
Like if you look at them like on the surface, there's really not. You know, like calamari cooks real fast, and it's kind of like the same though. That kind of like rubbery shellfish texture, like it's a texture thing too with it.
Behind the scenes at Comcast
SportsNet? It's a little different than what we do.
You guys aren't eating octopus on the set?
No. We're lucky we get a bag lunch.
This is a pretty just basic technique of scoring a tomato.
You're scoring
that's all we're going to do.
The underside.
We're going to score it, and we're just going to put it in the water and let it cook for like 20 seconds, and the skin will come off.
So the skin just peels right off easily.
Yep.
Basic culinary technique.
So Derrick, you want to just let them cook for like 20 seconds, and we can just take them out with a spoon and put them right in the bowl here.
Okay.
And then you're going to peel them. And
now
then we'll
you're
get
the chef
skin
at the house.
Absolutely not. I have a few specialties, but I leave all of that stuff to my wife. She's a gourmet cook.
I hear she's an
excellent she's very good.
Cook.
Very good at baking. Very good at cooking. That's why I have the girth I have now. I've never been longing for a meal. So
you're a proud recipient
Absolutely.
Of your wife's cooking.
Absolutely.
You know what? There's nothing wrong with that.
No, not at all. But you're a griller, though. I hear you're
I love
a big
grill.
Griller.
I love to grill.
Summertime.
Summertime. No, we even grill in the winter.
Do
a lot.
You really?
Yeah, we. It doesn't make a difference. As long as it's above freezing.
Yeah.
And I have three grills on my patio, and I have two Weber grills and a big charcoal grill. I don't do a lot of gas grilling. I like the charcoal flavor.
Yeah, I like the Weber.
Yeah.
So
charcoal.
Every chance we get, we grill.
Good. So. And you know, interesting. You talk about grilling in all months of the year. We have a grill right here in this set, so it's great.
Wow.
You know, you can enjoy grilled foods and that. There's nothing like a grilled burger.
Oh, no.
Derrick, we'll take those tomatoes out right now. Just be careful, You can put them right in the bowl there.
You're on the cook.
Octopus is great grilled, too. I mean, you see it on,
grilled octopus is great.
You know, I know it's a very, you'll see it on, a lot of Greek restaurants, just grilled octopus with some kind of salad, And we can do the same technique.
Marinated,
instead of sauteing it, you can marinate and grill it. Olive oil, balsamic vinegar, anything you want.
Herbs.
So we can see now it's taken on.
It looks
almost,
beautiful.
Yeah,
almost like a purpley.
Yeah, it's a much nicer color now. And you can see all this nice juice it's letting out.
Yes.
I mean, honestly, you could take a spoon right now and eat that, drink it, and it tastes
what
like the ocean.
What does it taste like? It tastes like the ocean.
I mean,
so it's a little bit of I would love to taste a little bit of that.
I don't want to be crazy about it, but.
No, it's interesting to me.
Yeah. It's good. Yeah, it's really good. Take a spoon, you can try it.
Yeah, I would love to.
Yeah. And it has just this nice, nice saltiness to it, nice little, what do you think? Isn't it
very
subtle?
Good.
Isn't it?
It's clean.
I'm game. I'll give it a shot.
It's,
yeah,
it's just a little bit of that salty.
I mean, it tastes
sea.
Like the ocean, right?
It does.
So with this,
it's
what
good.
We do?
Well, we're warming up to it, Derrick.
Oh, that is good.
We're warming up to the octopus.
No complaints so far.
Yeah.
It's
right?
pretty good.
So
I agree.
We just do really simple, something really simple with it. And,
mild flavor.
In this case, we're going to take
garlic.
A garlic head.
Okay.
And you don't even need to chop the garlic. We're just going to take this garlic head and split it in half, and you just put this right in there with it.
Wow.
So if you have a bigger pan, it's fine, but that's fine too. It doesn't take much room. We're gonna put a little bit of hot pepper flake.
Hot pepper.
Okay.
Good.
And that's pretty much it. And you can put a little, and it's not even really a necessary step, but like some people like a little bit of acid in it. You can put a little splash of sherry vinegar in it.
Okay.
And that's just really like a tablespoon or a little, even a little less.
Sure.
And we're just gonna take that, and it would be great. You can cover it with a little foil and just put it right in your oven. You can let this cook for, I mean, it depends on how tender you want it, but you can let it cook from anywhere from like an hour and a half to 2 hours to like 2.5 hours. It doesn't need much more than that. Be careful though. Do it at like 350, 325, because the juice, you want the juice to kind of remain in there and keep cooking it, because if the juice dries up, it's going to get like a little bit tough.
So I'm shocked at how easy it is to prepare.
No, it's real simple.
Really?
Yeah, there's no boiling.
It looks so intimidating.
Some people do these crazy things with like corks, and they kind of put cork in there. It's really,
not
one of those things that people complicate a lot. So Derrick, you want to peel these real quick? You can just, they're a little hot, but I think you'd be all right with it. We're gonna peel the skin off them, and I'll show you how we're gonna do these roasted tomatoes. And while you're doing that, I'll start on the aioli.
All right.
So you're gonna make homemade aioli?
Yeah, we're gonna make a real quick smoked paprika mayonnaise, which it's really basic. And so,
very good.
Yeah,
you're
I'll
gonna
stay
make
right
it over
Thank
here.
You.
Very good. And our set looks so lovely with all of your ingredients and also the beautiful flowers, compliments of Eventine Florist.
Yeah, they're very nice.
Right
nice
here
colors.
In the city, Rittenhouse Square. really lovely to be in this kitchen today.
It is very nice. Yeah, it's great to work in.
Wouldn't you love to live here? We were talking earlier about...
I actually just said the same thing. I would love to live here.
Western Union Building. We're right in the heart of all the energy in the city. Do you live in the city, Derrick?
No, I live in Delaware, as a matter of fact.
Do you?
Down in Bear, Delaware, yeah.
So you're in this suburban area?
Well, it's more like a farm area.
Is it?
Yeah,
okay.
We're out in the middle of nowhere. So you look to the left, you see a cow farm. You look to the right, you got a horse farm. So
that sounds very relaxing.
Well, you know, growing up in Wisconsin, you know, we like the outdoors. And so, you know, I just like being away. It's nice to work in the city. I love the hustle and bustle of the city. But I love getting away to peace and quiet,
sure.
You know, when I go home.
Doing some really simple things here. We just put one, we did one egg yolk. That'll make a nice amount of mayonnaise. We're gonna put maybe about a quarter teaspoon of smoked paprika in here. We'll start out real slow.
All right.
So just like when you're making any mayonnaise or any kind of emulsion, you wanna start it all slow. Okay, you can stop for a second.
So you're slowly incorporating the olive oil.
Yep, good.
All right, still slow?
Yeah, real slow.
Okay.
A little too fast. Slow down.
And this is smoked paprika?
Stop.
Okay.
Yep. I actually think we're broken. Derrick broke my mayonnaise. We'll blame it on him.
I didn't do it.
So you know what? Here's your other lesson. We'll show you how to fix your mayo real quick.
Well, that's great to know because this could easily happen
real,
to the home cook.
Real easy. So we're
when
gonna
you
put,
say broken.
Well, you can look at it and see that the result that we ended up with was kind of like it's not completely emulsified. It's kind of like.
We broke the egg.
No, you can't blame that on me.
Yeah, I was going to.
So cooking and sports, Derrick.
The two do not go together. But,
well, I think people who tailgate on any Sunday afternoon would maybe beg to differ with you, right?
Well, you know, but that kind of cooking entails just throwing it on a grill and cooking it to your discretion. You know, here, the steps here, it would take me 2 years to learn how to do this. So this is a little bit more high-tech than Sunday grilling out.
Absolutely.
Thank you.
Now, did you ever play sports?
Yeah, I played three sports in high school and two in college.
Wow.
Football and baseball in college, yeah. And never thought I would be doing this for a living. And when I started doing it, I was 21 years old. And I lived with three guys who I went to school with. And of course, the first 6 months of my career, every time I'd come home at night, they'd be on the floor laughing. And I kept saying, I got to get out of this business. And every time I said that, I got a better job. So here it is. I'm still
and
doing
you're
it.
Still doing it.
Still doing it.
And not, you must not, love it there.
Well, I do. You know what? It's a job. It's very few jobs that you know we have in this country where anybody would love to do your job. And I really feel you know, blessed to be able to do what I'm doing. And I enjoy it. I mean, I've been doing it for 29 years. And I've lived from San Diego, Milwaukee, Pittsburgh to here. And I've had a lot of fun, you know, just talking sports and in particular covering football.
Sure. Yeah. Sure, it's great to hear that you love what you do. And Anthony, you're also long in doing what you're doing.
Yeah.
You've been in the restaurant business for quite a while, you were telling me.
17 years, yeah. Born and raised in South Philly. Worked most of my career in Center City, and now I'm out in the suburbs with Alison. So.
And this Alison and Bluebell is reopening.
It is, yeah. We were very successful BYOB in Bluebell in Montgomery County. And
where do you want this?
We closed for about 3-4 months to do some renovations while we opened another restaurant.
We also opened Alison 2.
We did.
Just a few short miles down the road.
So we have our aioli done. It actually did come together. So I just added a little more the stuff that was broken back into the...
So to fix this?
Well, to fix it, you need to just go back to having a yolk and add the ingredient that was broken back into the yolk.
Okay,
the yolk,
I see.
It's just an emulsion of the yolk and the oil. And, you know, the little bit of lemon juice and everything allows it to come together. And we can actually add a little more oil into this to thicken it up a little bit, but it looks pretty good right now.
So this is smoked paprika?
It is, and it's a really nice high quality paprika.
Is it a specific type? It's like a Hungarian paprika?
It's mostly used in Spanish cooking, yeah. I mean, Hungarians are typically associated with, Hungarian cuisine is associated with paprika, but
sure, like goulashes.
Spanish cooking uses a lot of paprika. The tomatoes are real straightforward. We're just gonna, you wanna just cut them in half? And
sure.
You can just, there's a couple different ways you can cut them. One of the ways I like real easy that we do in the restaurant is just cut them right through the equator like that.
Okay.
Okay.
And you just keep them like that?
Yeah, we're going to keep them like that. You can squeeze a little tiny bit of the juice out.
Good. Now, Derrick, does your wife have any particular specialties that she makes at home that you are fond of?
Mexican food. She's
Mexican.
Really good with Mexican food, yes. You know, like I said, but everything she touched turns to gold usually, you know, so.
You are one lucky man.
Yes, I am.
I want to start off to get ready for the finished product, and we have an octopus here that's done. This has been cooking for about maybe 2 hours, 2.5 hours. It's reduced down a lot more. It's smaller. And the juice that's in there is reduced down nicely.
And the octopus itself cooks down. It almost shrinks in size.
Yeah, so this is what we ended up with.
And it's still in its whole state.
Yeah.
So it looks like an octopus still. Right, Derrick?
To me, it still looks like an octopus. Yeah. I'm not arguing.
It's gotten real tender.
It's
smiling. We're
going
to cut it and we're going to show you how.
Don't tell me that, please.
So real quick with the tomatoes, we're just going to, you can put them in a pan. After you peel them,
great.
Cut them.
Okay.
We can just put them. We can actually just put
in
a little olive oil on the bottom. Yeah.
Okay. And
just put them the same way they're sitting right there in the pan.
Very good.
Okay.
Anthony, is this your own particular recipe?
It is. I mean, it's just really taking some things that go really well with octopus. We know potatoes go well with it and tomatoes, and so I just kind of threw some ingredients together, and it worked out to be a really successful dish. I did it for a little while at Alison and Bluebell with. On top of flatbread, like a pizza flatbread, and it's not really even a necessary step, but so the tomatoes here are good. We're just going to put a little bit of salt. I put a little salt in there, a little pepper.
Mm-hmm.
There's already some olive oil on them, and you can actually just put a little sprinkle of chopped garlic in there.
Very
and you just
nice.
Put them in the oven. That's all, and you can let them cook down in a low oven for about 2-3 hours. You know, they caramelize a little bit and they come out pretty nice. So we got some here that are done.
Wow, very nice.
Okay. You can see the octopus cut up real nicely.
There it is, Derrick.
I'll let you taste a little piece.
I would love to.
Derrick?
Well, I got it. You guys are going to do it. I got to do it.
It's got really nice flavor.
Oh, my goodness. Mm-hmm. That is very good. Wow.
Mm-hmm. And I leave the tentacles on and everything. Okay.
Extremely tender.
So we'll move over here to the pan.
Meaty.
I'm going to put the potatoes
right?
in.
Very good. Yeah.
Fulfilling?
No, it's really good, isn't it? Nice salt. And if you notice, we didn't put any salt at all in there.
I love that it's not over seasoned.
It's just real basic.
No, very clean.
It has a lot
taste.
Of flavor on its own.
Mm-hmm.
So we're going to just saute some potatoes. And I do this almost as like a warm salad. It doesn't even need a lot in it, like in terms of like everything getting really hot. Just kind of like you can warm everything through. We're going to throw the octopus in here. So we have the octopus cut. And we can cut it, you know, a lot of different ways. You can leave it a little longer if you want. You can cut it in like, you know, 1-inch pieces.
Sure.
You can kind of leave some of these things there that kind of look nice. So I think that's a nice size portion.
See, Derrick, at the chef's kitchen, you never know what you're going to eat, right?
You know what?
Okay.
I've never felt so out of place, but I tell you what, I was impressed so far.
You know,
I'm impressed.
You know,
you'll know when
it's always going to be good.
Absolutely.
So the potatoes
that was definitely good.
Mm-hmm.
We're going to put a little pinch of garlic in here.
So are these?
Okay. These are fingerling potatoes that were just blanched.
So these were blanched potatoes then. And are they fingerling potatoes?
They are. They are. And you can use anything. Yukon Gold is just cut.
Mm-hmm. Because I guess just cut it according to size.
Yep.
Noticed you were talking a lot about...
And we can take it off the heat at that point. Excuse me.
Okay.
And we'll put the octopus in. And we know that it's fully cooked, so we're just kind of like warming it through.
Warming it through, kind of condensing all the flavors.
Yeah, and we'll bring it all together. What were you going to say?
This is a popular Spanish-influenced dish.
Absolutely.
Do you like Spanish cooking?
I do, yeah. I mean, I like Italian cooking. Spanish cooking sort of reminds me of it. It's very reminiscent of it, but it has...
I agree.
It has some really different things. You know, like they cook more with... It's some different flavors. It's the ingredients I associate with Spanish cooking are like always like, you know, pork products, potatoes,
sure.
Octopus, you know, some unusual seafood ingredients.
Mm-hmm.
So we just put the potatoes together. We threw the tomatoes in there.
Lots of fresh
herbs.
We threw
a lot of nice parsley. We threw some arugula that I had just to kind of give it a little crunch to it.
Mm-hmm.
We're going to squeeze a half a lemon in there.
And brighten it up a little bit.
And just put it all together. I think that looks really nice.
It looks great.
Nice warm salad. I mean,
colorful.
It's good for summertime.
Anytime, really.
Yep. And we can even put a little tiny bit of paprika in there if you want, just to give it a little...
Finish it off at the end
color.
You'll have to invite the rest of the guys over at Comcast SportsNet.
You know what? I don't know if you want to feed all those guys.
That's they have
different.
Big appetites?
Oh, they all have big appetites, yes.
We're ready to plate.
We have a beautiful rosé from Côte de Rhône.
So that rosé is a nice wine to match with the octopus.
Very
nice.
Got
a little bit of spice in the octopus. And
we've enjoyed some wonderful Côte de Rhône wines today from a beautiful region in France. Okay, so we are ready, Chef, right?
Okay.
You're gonna just dress it up with your
homemade
aioli?
Yep. We have the, just real simple, we'll just put this on top. Just drape it right over it.
Mm, very nice. And it, okay. The aioli did come together nicely.
Yeah, it looks nice. You don't want it too thick. And we'll top with a little more of the arugula.
Nice touch.
Just put that on top. And if you have some nice Spanish olive oil, you can finish with a little tiny bit of Spanish olive
Dress
oil.
Dress it up.
And here you have it. Spanish octopus with potatoes, tomatoes.
Nice Mediterranean style fare.
Yeah,
wouldn't you say?
Healthy dish. It's a nice dish. There you go.
Okay. Here you go, Chef.
Thank you.
For you. And thank you so much, Derrick, for coming here today
on
the Chef's Kitchen. It's been great having you. We've had a lot of fun.
Pleasure being here with you guys.
And let's taste it.
All right. Well, thank you.
Let's give it a shot. Okay. Grab a fork there. Nice aioli.
Oh, my goodness.
What do you think?
Definitely an upgrade from burgers and fries.
Wow. Bring those Comcast guys a plate of this.
Eat your heart out, SportsNet.
This is fantastic, Chef.
Very nice.
Again, I love the simple flavors. The octopus speaks for itself. Doesn't need a lot of dressing, but the aioli is just enough.
Yeah, it comes
out
nicely.
No smoky flavor. Derrick, you are always welcome back in the Chef's Kitchen. You're a lot of fun.
You know what? Thank you so much for letting me be here.
I hope that maybe you'll share some of your wife's secrets, huh?
Well, I'd have to get approval from her first, but definitely this is an upgrade.
Maybe she can even cook here in the Chef's Kitchen.
Oh, you know what? She might even consider doing
that. Maybe we'll take her up on that.
All right.
Would love it.
I would love to have
Thank you, Chef. Anthony Bonnet from Alison of Bluebell.
Thank you, Doug.
Flowers for the Chef's Kitchen provided by Eventine Design, Philadelphia's premier florist located at the Rittenhouse Hotel and Condominiums.